And welcome back, everyone, to Storytime with the Wimberlys. Grab your pillow and blankets, and let's get ready for Storytime. Today's story is David Goes to School by David Shannon. Let's get ready to read. David Goes to School by David Shannon. David's teacher always said, "No, David. No yelling, no pushing, no running in the halls." Here's David, and he looks like he's running in the hallways. "David, you're tardy." Here's David. He's peeping around the door, and he looks like he's about to walk into his classroom. But he's late. So tardy is another word for late. "Sit down, David." David's being silly. He's at the front of his classroom. He's at the chalkboard, and he's sticking out his tongue and being silly. "Don't chew gum in class." David's sitting at his desk. He has a red book, a blue and white striped shirt, and he's pulling the gum out of his mouth. It's pink bubble gum, and he's playing with it. "David, raise your hand." David is sitting at his desk, and he's standing up to his feet, and his mouth is wide open, so we know that he's talking. But the girl who was sitting next to him, she had her hand raised. So in class, when we want to speak, we're supposed to raise our hands, and David didn't. "Keep your hands to yourself." Here's David, and he's sitting at, well, he's not sitting. He's leaning over his desk, and they were doing art, because you can see his handprint in red, and his green and blue swirls on his paper. And he's reaching over, and he has red paint on his hand, to the girl who's sitting next to him. "Pay attention." David is sitting at his desk, but he's turned his head towards the window. So he's looking outside, and he's not paying attention to what his teacher is saying. And if you look in the sky, this cloud right here, it looks like a dinosaur. And we have a globe here, a potato, and a rocket. "Wait your turn, David." So all the kids are in the cafeteria, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kids who are waiting in line to get their food. And David, he's walking up and he is jumping ahead in line. We're not supposed to do that. We're supposed to wait in line and be patient. "I don't care who started it." So we have David and another little kid, and they were eating lunch in the cafeteria, and it looks like they were throwing food at each other. We have a banana on the floor, milk, orange, a half a sandwich eaten, we got spaghetti on their faces, in their head, we have a tomato squished on the wall. They made a big mess. David, recess is over. So this is the playground or the play area at the school, and there's no one out there except David and a red ball. "Shh." It looks like David is in the library and is using his pencils as drumsticks to drum on his book and make loud, loud sounds. But are we supposed to be loud in the library? No, we're not supposed to be loud in the library. We are supposed to be quiet. Shh. Again? David is standing at his desk, and he looks like he has to go to the bathroom. Poor David. That's it, mister. You're staying after school. So David was sitting at his desk, and he decided to draw all over his desk. Are we supposed to draw on our desk at school? No, we're not. So he drew a pig, an alien spaceship, his dog, and a bunch of stick figures, two stars, and Saturn. David, have you finished? So, David was staying after school because he drew on his desk, and for his punishment, he had to clean all the desk in the classroom. Is he done? It looks like he is, because they are shiny and clean. Good job, David. Look, David, he got a star from his teacher for doing such a good job for cleaning off his desk. Yes, David, you can go home now. So here's David, and he's so excited to be out of school, and his friends right here are waiting on him, and they're waving at him. If you like this story and want to see more videos, please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel. See you tomorrow for another bedtime story. Good night. And sweet dreams. The end.